Jorge Ramos also works as an anchor at Univision, which, unlike RT, has not been forced to register as a foreign agent. He also wrote the book Stranger, The Challenge of a Latino Immigrant in the Trump Era. We spoke with him just a minute ago. Jorge, thanks for joining us. I appreciate it.
Great to be here. Thank you.
So the first and maybe most important question is, why should we let these asylum seekers, these migrants, into our country?
I think the United States is becoming a hostile, even dangerous country for refugees and for immigrants. And I think we have a long tradition of being generous, of accepting other immigrants from countries where they're fleeing violence and poverty and lack of democracy. I think that's precisely what the United States is. And at the end, Tucker, I think it's simply a matter of deciding what kind of country do we want to be. And it seems at this point that we are talking about only a few hundred refugees. And putting it in context, from the 65 million refugees that there are in the world, the United States accepted only 84,000 in 2016, and with President Trump, it's going to be even less. So it's simply a matter of deciding what kind of country do we want to be.
Well, we've accepted about 13 million refugees, economic refugees, who are in our country now illegally. But back up for one second. You said that this is a hostile, dangerous place for refugees. Then why would you want them to come here if the United States is so dangerous?
Well, I mean, that's much, much better than if you're a father in Tegucigalpa or San Pedro Sula and you have a son and that son wants to be recruited by the gangs, or if they threaten your only daughter, they want to rape her. What will you do? I mean, maybe the only option for them is to come to the United States.
Oh, but it's not the only option. I mean, look, I understand. Look, I love this country. I was born here. I'm not a citizen of any other country. Mm-hmm. Obviously, I'm for America, and I plan to stay. So you don't need to convince me why people would want to come. I understand why they would.
Exactly.
But in order to get here, they pass through Mexico, which is, by many measures, a rich country. It's got the 15th largest economy in the world. There are 30 Mexican billionaires. Got a bigger economy than Saudi Arabia. They're sleeping on the street in Tijuana. Why doesn't the Mexican government help them?
Well, it's first of all, they don't want to stay in Mexico. They want to come to the United States. Okay. And second of all, if you're fleeing violence, if you're fleeing gangs in Honduras or El Salvador or Guatemala, why would you want to go to Mexico when in the last 5 years, more than 100,000 people were killed by drug violence? Would you stay in Mexico? Of course not. It doesn't make absolutely
sense. Well, no, I mean,
it doesn't make any sense. So they want to come to the United States.
Probably want to fly business class to Zurich and move to the Alps. But, I don't get to because it's not my country. So
you want to close the United States. That's what you want to do. You want to close the United States?
I mean,
that's the kind of country you want to be in?
I want to revert to what we were, which is a country of laws, where people can come here, but they do so legally. We have over 1 million people come here every year legally. Mm-hmm. They fill out the paperwork, they get in line from around the world, and I don't know why that system doesn't work. A million people a year is a lot.
They want to come here legally. They're waiting in Tijuana. It's just that for 2 days they haven't been allowed even to talk to an agent.
They're not trying to get here legally.
On the U.S. side.
They're trying to come here and claim asylum, which in effect means a court date will be set and the overwhelming majority will not show up for court and they will blend in with the other 13 million illegals already here.
I mean, you're criminalizing them. No, that's not true. I mean, they're fleeing violence. They're fleeing gangs.
How do you know that? Wait, hold on. Wait, you keep making these statements. What do you know about them?
We talk to them because we have reporters talking to them because we know who they are. We talk in Spanish every single day with them. We've been following them for 25 days. That's why we know who they are. That's why we know that they're not criminals and terrorists. And they're not rapists. That's why we know who they are.
Did you talk to the one who was a member of MS-13 who was caught last week, who admitted he was a member of MS-13? What did he say when you talked to him?
Well, I haven't talked to him. And again,
if you want to criminalize the whole group simply because of one person, I don't even know what's your source. Hold on, slow down. Stop the word tsunami for two seconds.
That's not the kind of country.
It's the Mexican citizen lecturing me about what kind of country America is. I love that. But let me ask you this. One of them said he was from MS-13. That was his description of his own affiliation. You're saying I'm criminalizing him by repeating what he said about himself. So maybe what you're really engaging in is propaganda, not fact-finding.
No. What I'm saying is that if you want to criminalize the whole caravan, which is not composed by bad hombres, and as you know, there is no invasion, if you want to criminalize the hundreds of them.
Oh, there's an invasion.
What
13 million people
said,
here illegally? I think that's an invasion. Look, if 13 million illegals showed up in Mexico tomorrow and wouldn't leave, And if people from other countries like you called anyone who wanted to make them leave a racist, I think you would call it what it is, which is an invasion.
No, what I'm simply saying is that if they're fleeing, if they're asking for political asylum, we have to listen to them. And on the other hand,
why do we have to listen to them?
Well, because that's the long tradition that we've had, just to accept and protect those who are vulnerable, those who are being persecuted.
Well, why doesn't Mexico, with an economy larger than Saudi Arabia's, protect them? Okay, but hold on. Why is it America's unique obligation to take in, I mean, there are 1.2 billion people in Africa. All of them have lower standards of living than Americans. Many of them are living in violent places. Mm-hmm. Do they all have a right to come here? It's a real question. Do they?
Could it be because we are the most powerful and the richest country in the world?
We're not
and we
the
want
richest,
to be an example of democracy
actually,
and equality.
Right. Circa 1955. That would be China, which doesn't believe in diversity or immigration, just so you know.
Well,
do they have any obligation?
Because they are in our hemisphere, and we're also responsible for that. I mean, they're fleeing violence, right? So why do you think they're fleeing? These drug wars in Central America and Mexico are not happening just because it's a TV project. No, it's happening simply because there are more than 25 million Americans who use illegal drugs, and we're also responsible for everything that's happening in this hemisphere.
We're going to blame the junkies. So Mexico sends in fentanyl, heroin. Yes, it does. Mexico is now the largest manufacturer of crystal meth. We used to make it ourselves. Now they make it. They kill tens of thousands of Americans every year, and those families are the ones responsible.
Who are the consumers? U.S. citizens, 25 million U.S. citizens who are consumers of drugs. We're also responsible for that violence.
Oh, we're responsible for heroin addiction. So someone who's taking heroin, he's responsible. The junkie living on the street is responsible for these people being here. Is that what you're saying?
No, what I'm saying is that when you have about 25 million U.S. citizens who use illegal drugs, it has consequences in the whole hemisphere. Drugs are coming from Colombia and Peru, crossing Central America and Mexico. And the violence that is happening in those places is also partly responsible for the consumers in this country.
Oh, I understand. So 60,000 people die of drug ODs last year. Most of those drugs came from Mexico, but it's our fault. So not only do we have to drop our borders, ignore our own laws, take any poor person around the world who wants to come here, but we have to do it because we're immoral, because we're dying of drug ODs? That's the argument,
you
really?
So you think that the U.S. and the U.S. consumers have absolutely no responsibility for the drug wars in Mexico, in Colombia, in Peru, and in Central America? They're completely linked. Absolutely, they're completely linked. And guess what? Not only that, how about the guns and the rifles being used by drug traffickers? Oh. Where do you think they get
those? It's funny. Typically, when you're trying to get someone to do something nice for you, like taking all your poor people?
So, yes, there's responsibility. And we in the United States, we have responsibility for the things that are happening in our
own hemisphere. You're a Mexican citizen. You voted the Mexican presidential election. I just find it amazing that you can demand compassion from Americans.
I'm also a U.S. citizen.
I guess, but you voted in the Mexican election, so I mean,
I vote in the Mexican election,
right?
And I vote in the U.S. election. I know it's confusing for you, but that's what happens. And there are millions of people around the world with dual citizenship. I'm just one of them.
Yeah. Well, I'm opposed to it, if I can say that for obvious reasons. But it's just funny how we have a moral obligation because we're bad people to subsidize the rest
of the
world.
Because we're the richest and the most powerful country in the world, and many people want to come here, and we're an example of democracy and generosity. I think that's the right idea
for America. Talk about blaming the victim. Jorge, it was great to see you.
Thank you, Tucker.
Thank you. The Mexican government abetted illegal immigration into this country, as it has done for many years. Well, tonight the caravan is on our southern border. Rather than wait for the crossing station at San Ysidro to open, many of them just jumped the fence. Some waved Honduran flags when they got to the top. And that tells you everything. When you arrive in a country to contribute to it and to assimilate into its culture, you don't wave the flag of a foreign nation. That's what you do in triumph when you invade a country. According to Border Control, at least one member of the caravan has already admitted to being a member of MS-13. All of this should worry us. There are only a few hundred people in this caravan, but there are billions more around the world who live amid violence and poverty, and virtually every single one of them would like to relocate to San Diego. The left argues we have no moral right to stop any of them from doing that. Here's attorney Nicole Ramos of Tijuana denouncing the U.S. government as criminal for trying to enforce our own federal law. Watch.
The message for Customs and Border Protection: stop rejecting asylum seekers who try to present themselves at the port of entry. You know what you're doing. You know you turn people away. You complain that they are breaking the law by entering illegally. You are breaking the law, and break the law. That's why we have caravans.
Yeah, that's definitely someone you want in control over public policy, screaming into a bullhorn. This is not immigration. Immigration happens with the consent of the host country. This is happening by force, without our consent. A government that cared about its own citizens wouldn't allow it to happen. Bad things happen when you leave the door open. Every homeowner knows that. The left is demanding that we leave our door open. Any attempt at self-defense is immoral, they tell us, from the safety of their segregated neighborhoods where they all live. Illegal immigrants are amazing people, they say, far better than you are, Mr. Entitled American. Last week, we had a conversation with Enrique Acevedo of Univision, and he made that point. If you're right up against a country that's totally out of control, as people are shooting each other in the numbers you just described, Why wouldn't you be terrified to let them in?
Well, I think you're not getting the criminals. You're getting the best of Mexico, the people who are willing to work two or three shifts a day, the people who are law-abiding citizens and are proactive enough to try to provide a better future for their family, the people who are fleeing that violence. That's what you're getting, not rapists and criminals
But we don't know that, of course, because we have more than 10... No, actually, we don't.